Hello everyone. Now in this session, we will be doing a new thing, which is nothing but algebra of complex numbers, which we have done in the previous sessions, but in the argand plane. Now in my previous sessions, at one place I have mentioned that whatever we do in Cartesian form is not of great help. We may have to switch over to polar form as soon as possible and take help of the argand plane. So that same exercise we will be doing here in this particular session. Now my first thing with which I start is addition and subtraction, these operations on argand plane, how we would be marking z1 plus z2 or z1 minus z2. And for that, I start with z1 as r1 times cos theta 1 plus I sine theta 1 and z2 as r2 times cos theta 2 plus I sine theta 2. Mind you, please, here deliberately I have not written z1 and z2 in terms of Cartesian form, means x plus iy form. I have not written because I want to take help of argand plane that I already know, and hence I write z1 and z2 in polar form itself. Now, the moment I say argand plane, obviously I will have to draw real axis, imaginary axis, show the origin, and since we are talking about z1 and z2, so corresponding positions where z1 and z2 would lie on argand plane, that is important. So first thing what I do is plot point P, which would represent Z1, and point Q, which would represent Z2. So I show point P and I show point Q. Now what we do is, we actually complete the parallelogram. I have written their name O, P, R, Q. R I have not yet shown in the picture. O, P, so obviously you will have to join O, P, then go up to a point, say R, and then join that R to Q and Q to O and complete parallelogram as shown in the figure. Now, R position is important. And I understand that vector OR will represent Z1 plus Z2. In last session, I mentioned that a complex number can be treated as a vector. So, OP, this vector, vector OP bar, would represent Z1. And what about PR? PR is in the same direction as OQ. Since it's a parallelogram, so length is also same as OQ. So I can treat vector OQ bar is same as vector PR bar. So vector OP bar plus vector PR bar. Whatever vectors you have learnt in physics that you can apply here. And I get OR bar as the answer. So Z1 plus Z2 would be represented by nothing but vector OR bar. Okay. And one more thing I realized. It should be about argument part also. Now, Z1 plus Z2 represent OR bar. And what about argument? Argument of Z1 plus Z2 is angle ROM. That means what OR makes with real axis, that angle will have to be written as the argument part. So, in this way, I have shown the addition. Now, can you try using your knowledge of vectors for the subtraction? That is again easy to understand. And I'm giving you a hint that it is nothing but PQ or QP bar. That would be representing Z1 minus Z2 or Z2 minus Z1. Okay. So vector PQ bar is Z2 minus Z1. And corresponding the angle would be nothing but angle LNQ in the figure. So that is nothing but argument part of the difference. So sum of two complex numbers and difference of two complex numbers can be shown on the argand plane. This comes in this particular part, and please, since you are doing it for the first time, keep revising this part. If you give geometrical approach to your complex number problems, it would be quick to answer the questions. From especially competitive examinations point of view, I am saying that geometrical approach is extremely of great help. Okay, I move to the next part, and it is multiplication of complex numbers, which would be shown now in the argand plane. Again, Z1 I start with as R1 cos theta 1 plus I sin theta 1, R2 cos theta 2 plus I sin theta 2 as Z2, and then I go for Z1, Z2. Go by term by term multiplication or use the properties and write it as, since mod of Z1, Z2 is same as mod Z1 into mod Z2. So R1, R2 will become the product part will become nothing but modulus, and cos of theta 1 plus theta 2, I am directly writing reason. Argument of Z1, Z2 is argument of Z1 plus argument of Z2. This property also we have done. Using that property also, you can directly write product Z1, Z2 as R1 R2 into cos of theta 1 plus theta 2 plus I times theta 1 plus theta 2. Now, this is something what we want to show now in the argand plane. Okay. Now, for that again, I will have to draw real axis, imaginary axis, name the origin, and show the points P and Q representing Z1 and Z2. Show PZ1, show QZ2. And corresponding their arguments also, you can show theta 1 and theta 2. And also, length OP would be nothing but R1. Length OQ would be nothing but R2. This is something what we can see from the picture. Now, my job is to show finally Z1, Z2. Now, we know the argument of new number, which is Z1, Z2, is theta 1 plus theta 2. So, I will have to draw a line OR, which makes with real axis angle theta 1 plus theta 2. And on this line, I will have to mark that point R such that length OR is R1, R2, means mod Z1 into mod Z2. If you plot that point R, then that point R represents nothing but Z1, Z2. Now, understand one thing, that theta 1 plus theta 2, that means you are talking about rotation. And mod Z1 into mod Z2, that is R1, R2 part, that represents the shear. So, basically, to get position of R, you are needing two things. One is that you are increasing the magnitude, right? So, that is called shear. It could be decreasing also, depending on the number what you are choosing. And you are rotating line OP in the direction of OR or OQ in the direction of OR. So, that depends on two things. Either you rotate OP or rotate OQ. So, basically, total transformation is in two parts, shear and rotation. So, the entire transformation is called spiral transformation. Mind you, please, these are the names. I wanted to give you an authentic ways. My more emphasis would be on the diagram part and the application to the problem. Okay. If mod Z2 is 1, then what will happen? If mod Z2 is 1, then modulus of the product Z1, Z2 and modulus of Z1, they will be nothing but same. So, basically, there is no increment in the length part. It's only a case of rotation. So, this is called pure rotation. And if you have theta 2 equal to 0, then there is no rotation. It is just case of pure shear. So, these are the additional names which I am trying to give you. Maybe in some question, name like pure rotation or pure shear comes. You should be able to understand what it means. Now, to get argument of Z1, Z2, we can do it in two ways. One is by rotating OP or by rotating OQ. If you are rotating OQ, OQ already has theta 2 in it, that angle. Now, I want theta 1 to be added. That means I will have to add argument of Z1. That means I will have to rotate it by argument of Z1, that particular angle. Or if you are rotating OP, OP already includes angle theta 1. So, that will have to be rotated by angle theta 2. So, which is equivalent to rotating by an angle which is equal to argument of Z2. So, which one you want to rotate, that is left to you. Either you rotate OP or you rotate OQ. If you are rotating OP, then you will have to rotate it by angle theta 2. Now, this is something about the multiplication part. Now, move to next. And that is nothing but the division part. Division also goes exactly on the similar lines. You take Z1 as R1 into cos theta 1 plus I sin theta 1. Z2 equal to R2 into cos theta 2 plus I sin theta 2. And go for the division part, that means Z1 upon Z2. And use the properties directly if possible. Argument of Z1 upon Z2 is the difference of the argument. And modulus of the part Z1 upon Z2 is R1 upon R2. So you can directly write Z1 upon Z2 equal to R1 upon R2 into cos of theta 1 minus theta 2 plus I times sin theta 1 minus theta 2. Now, if I go further and if I have to draw or plot this everything, whatever I am writing there, this will need obviously real axis and imaginary axis. So, I draw real axis, I draw imaginary axis, show origin also and plot points P representing Z1 and point Q representing Z2. So, I plot P representing Z1 and Q representing Z2 and join them to origin. So, OP, OQ, that all is shown in the picture. Okay. Now, from here, what we observe is that angle theta 1 you can show, angle theta 2 you can show, length OP you can show, which is R1, length OQ you can show, which is R2, and draw that line OR such that now OR should be in the direction such that argument should come out as theta 1 minus theta 2, and point R would be placed such that length OR should be nothing but R1 upon R2. Okay, so we do that. I take a line and I'm showing R. What kind of line OR I have drawn? It is obtained by rotating OP in the clockwise direction by angle theta 2. So that OR makes angle with the real axis theta 1 minus theta 2. First thing is, to do the entire exercise, you will have to have hold on trigonometry. You should be able to understand what we mean by theta 1 minus theta 2. Theta 1 minus theta 2 means original angle was theta 1. And you want minus theta 2. The moment you say minus, that means you will have to move in the clockwise direction. So move in the clockwise direction by theta 2 angle and then draw the line. And mark point R on it such that length OR is R1 upon R2. And hence, position R will represent Z1 upon Z2. So I think picture and the explanation, when you try to correlate, you will be able to understand that how do we plot Z1 upon Z2. And before that, we have done Z1 into Z2. Now, these two things, more than addition, I would say, or subtraction, multiplication and division are extremely important and make use of Argand diagram in case of these two operations. They will solve your problem, within no time. So please try to get hold on these two particular things. When I come in the next session, I will come again with something new. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you have liked the video, please click here to subscribe. And if you wish to buy the book, you will have to click on this side. Thank you.